After Joe Biden's strong performance at the State of the Union address last week, Republicans are now insisting that Biden must be on drugs, despite the fact that Donald Trump is the one whose White House had a very real drug scandal that keeps getting worse. For more on this, it's time for a closer look. Fox News and the Republican Party could have spent the last 4 years crafting an agenda of their own and presenting to the American people an alternative vision to what they would do if they were returned to power. Instead, they spent most of that time telling everybody that Joe Biden has dementia.
Do you see in Joe Biden a cognitive decline? And if so, is that a danger to the country?
I do. I think most of us do.
We have a president that clearly is not cognitively up to this job.
There's a mental decline.
This man's got cognitive issues related to his age.
He's in serious mental decline. I mean, it's so obvious now.
I don't think there's any doubt Biden's senile.
It's a risk to run a candidate who may be senile. We have no clue what Joe Biden actually thinks or even if he's capable of thinking.
You know who lights up for ice cream? Children and the elderly. There's a reason caregivers deliver ice cream to their patients in nursing homes.
Look, the man has dementia. There's no doubt about it. I've talked to doctors. He actually displays symptoms that two gerontologists told me are classic symptoms of middle-level dementia. It's not just my opinion. It's the opinion of a number of doctors I've actually, interviewed.
So you talked to a bunch of doctors who told you all the symptoms of dementia. Are you sure they weren't your doctors? I would say the first sign of dementia is going in for a doctor's appointment and thinking you're the one interviewing the doctor. Thanks for letting me interview you for my new talk show. Can you see my ass in this gown? Here are a few other signs of mid-level dementia. You think there's a massive secret conspiracy involving voting machines and a dead Venezuelan dictator to rig a presidential election. You show up to a landscaping company thinking it's a luxury hotel. Your skull starts leaking on national TV, and you routinely make this face. That's the face you make when a doctor shows you an X-ray of your own brain and there's nothing there. Also, I do have to touch on this real quick.
You know who lights up for ice cream? Children and the elderly.
You know who else lights up for ice cream? Everyone. I, for example, am neither a child nor an elderly person, but I also enjoy ice cream as documented on national television. It's impossible to eat ice cream and not look like you're enjoying it. And believe me, once the president started talking about the Middle East, I tried. I had nowhere to put it. It's literally designed that you can't put it down, which did inspire a great business idea. Do you love ice cream? Do you wish you had somewhere to put it when TV cameras are trained on your every move because you happen to be standing next to the president when he makes international news? Introducing the cone holster. It's an on-the-go ice cream cone holster you can wear on your belt. Now you'll never have to look silly while standing next to a world leader during an impromptu press conference in an ice cream store. Call now to order 1-800-OH-MAN, set the up. Where was I? Yes, dementia. The point is, Republicans spent years relentlessly constructing an absurd image of Biden as a cognitively impaired dementia patient. And in one night, that already ridiculous narrative crumbled after Biden's strong performance at the State of the Union address. Instant polls showed the speech was a success, and it was so strong, Biden was cracking jokes about it afterward when he was caught talking on a hot mic to a member of Congress.
Nobody's gonna talk about cognitive impairment now.
Yeah. You were on fire, too.
Kind of wish sometimes there was cognitive impairment.
You could tell Biden felt good about his speech from the way he was yucking it up like he just hit an inside-the-park home run in a company softball game. Hey, folks, when I ran at third base, I wasn't sure I was gonna make it. I'm not kidding around. You should have seen the faces on those jerks from Pep Boys. They couldn't believe they lost to Joe Biden Auto Parts. No joke! Of course, it wasn't an entirely flawless night. Biden did not seem to realize he was on a hot mic when he started talking about his relationship with Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu until an aide interrupted him.
I told him, baby, show me pieces. I said, baby, you know I can't come to Jesus.
Sir, just...
That was good.
You know Biden's in a good mood when he's like, the entire world heard that? Well, f*** it. Any mic is a hot mic when I'm spitting, son. But more importantly, you're going to have a come-to-Jesus meeting with Netanyahu now? Why didn't you have that meeting 5 months ago? Was Jesus not answering your calls? You should have left a message saying, call me back right away. It's about your hometown. What are you waiting for? The next impromptu press conference inside a combination Taco Bell Pizza Hut? As we've said on this show before, the only way out of this horrific situation is an immediate lasting ceasefire and the safe return of all hostages. And in a follow-up interview, Biden said that's what he wants too.
You were caught on a hot mic after your State of the Union address talking to Secretary of State Antony Blinken and Senator Michael Bennett saying, quote, I told him, BB, and don't repeat this, but you and I are going to have a come to Jesus meeting. What do you mean by that?
What I meant was, it's an expression used in the southern part of my state, meaning a serious meeting. He's hurting Israel more than helping Israel by making the rest of the world. It's contrary to what Israel stands for. And I think it's a big mistake. So I want to see a ceasefire.
If you want to see a ceasefire, then you have to actually do something to achieve it. You have to push for it. You have to use your leverage as president to get it. You can't just wish for it out loud like you're throwing pennies into a mall fountain and then heading off to the DQ and the food court. Nonetheless, Democrats and the Biden team were clearly pleased by the president's performance during the speech. Instant polls show voters were pleased, too. But the way you know for sure that the speech went well is how much Republicans have been in hysterics over it. Sean Hannity was obsessed with one phrase in particular when describing Biden's performance.
Tonight, America saw, let's say, a very different Joe Biden. I might call him Jacked Up Joe. Jacked Up Joe screaming lie after lie. Jacked Up Joe perhaps overcompensated. Now, the difference between Jacked Up Joe tonight and his recent public appearances, very angry, very jacked up, you might say. This angry, jacked up Joe Biden. What was your reaction to jacked up, angry, bitterly partisan Joe Biden tonight? Jacked Up Joe Biden's State of the Union address is in the books. Let's get your overall reaction to Jacked Up Joe.
When the Biden team heard Hannity say the words Jacked Up Joe that many times, I bet they said, thank you for the kick-ass new nickname. Biden might be behind Trump in a recent poll by 4 points, but when you change his name to Jacked Up Joe, he's up 45. Jacked up. The way he says jacked is not, I'm not okay with. Jacked Up Joe, that's how you say it. Jacked Up Joe. Republicans keep coming up with better messaging for Biden than Biden does. He co-opted the Dark Brandon memes and made them a staple of his campaign. Meanwhile, Democrats came up with the slogan, and this is real, together we will defeat Donald Trump again. Here's how you know a campaign slogan sucks, when it's two sentences. That's like if Obama's was, yes, we can win an election, I mean. By contrast, Jacked Up Joe is awesome. That makes him sound like a professional wrestler. Biden should start entering speeches with a hottie on each arm. I'm not kidding around here, brother. You're gonna regret the day you met Jacked Up Joe. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, folks. And he wasn't the only Fox host concluded that Biden must have been on drugs.
I'm not a doctor, but they're giving him something. All of a sudden, this guy is, like, amped. On speed or something.
Nobody has ever needed to say, I'm not a doctor less than Jesse Waters. And if he was a doctor, you know he'd be one of those first-name doctors, like a chiropractor or a wedding DJ. Dr. Jesse is here to cure your dance fever and adjust your L5. Also, let me ask you, who you think is more likely to be on mind-altering drugs? A president who gives a perfectly normal State of the Union address or a member of Congress who shows up to an official work event dressed like this? That's Marjorie Taylor Greene at the State of the Union. Look, she got fired from a Russian airline for wearing too much flair. Although there's nothing I can say about her dumb Halloween getup that can't be summed up by Joe Biden's reaction when he saw her. Watch Biden's face in this clip when he walks into the chamber and sees Greene's stupid costume. That's how insane she looks. She got Joe Biden to make the Rudy face. What's especially galling about insisting that Biden is on drugs is that in reality, it's the Trump White House that had a very real documented drug scandal. And that's not just a salacious rumor. That's according to a government report.
A new report from the Inspector General at the Defense Department says the Trump White House was, quote, awash with speed and prescription drugs. The report says drugs, including the sleep medication Ambien and the anti-sleep med Provigil, were given out without identifying who was receiving them. In a new Rolling Stone article on the DOD report, a former staffer told the publication the anti-anxiety drug Xanax was also handed out, although it was not mentioned in the IG's report.
That's right. The Trump White House was allegedly awash in everything from speed to Ambien to Provigil to Xanax. Now, we can't legally say that Trump is on drugs, but he does look like every side effect from a drug commercial. Sweats like crazy, gets cotton mouth, has trouble seeing the teleprompter, and glitches like his brain is an exploding Rube Goldberg machine.
We are a nation that just recently heard that Saudi Arabia and Russia will we have become a nation like nobody thought possible. By far the most disgraceful part of Joe Biden's service is the divisive and angry speech. So angry. All compliments of an incompetent Biden administration.
Honestly, I hope this dude is on drugs. If that's how his brain works, stone cold sober, he should see one of Rudy's doctors. And it gets worse. There were reportedly even more drugs floating around the Trump White House.
So here's the headline. It's kind of, can't mistake it. Trump's White House was awash in speed and Xanax. The Pentagon included a document that showed basically an order form for medications that were ordered by the White House medical unit, that it was doling out, and it was stuff like fentanyl and ketamine, also morphine and Ambien, and a lot of an upper called Provigil.
I'm starting to think Trump's always raging against the cartels because he considers them the competition. We have to stop fentanyl from crossing our borders because it's bringing down the price of our White House fentanyl. This is just me, but I'd much rather the White House be super into ice cream than, you know, opioids. The right spent 4 years pretending Biden was senile, only to discover that he's not, and now they're panicking. And all the while, it was the Trump White House that was reportedly awash in all kinds of drugs. For all we know, they were sprinkling Adderall in their coffee and calling it
Jacked Up Joe.
This has been A Closer Look.
Or don't.